Good morning, my friends, and welcome to worship here at Laboratory Presbyterian Church on our virtual worship service. Let's get the elephant in the room out of the way first. Yes, new robe. Do you like it or do you love it? Leave a comment in the chat window, and while you're over there, say hello to each other this morning as our way of extending fellowship to one another. We actually have lots coming up in the coming days, even though we are shut down, so let me give you a preview of the week to come. On Wednesday, December 23rd, we will be having our last live jam of the Advent season. Tune in right here on the YouTube channel at 6:30 for that. Then on December the 24th, on Thursday, Christmas Eve, we'll have two worship services. The first will be at 7 o'clock here and outside. Weather permitting is a very strong term. I would have this worship service in any weather conditions. So if you're interested in being in person for a couple of hymns and a Christmas message, please join us at 7 o'clock here at the new Christmas tree out front. Then at 9 o'clock, for those of you that don't want to brave the elements, that's okay. We've got you covered too. At 9 o'clock here on the YouTube channel, we will have our virtual Christmas Eve offering. Again, I'll be there on the chat window. We can all share in the celebration of Christmas together. On that note, we still need folks to send videos of yourselves holding lit candles. And in fact, we've made it easier to do so. If you go to the church website, which is listed here across the screen, down at the bottom on the far right, you'll see an image of a candle. If you click that, you'll be given an opportunity to just upload those files straight to me, and we'll have them ready to go for Christmas Eve. I would love it if you could do that sometime before the end of the day tomorrow, Monday the 21st. More announcements to come, I'm sure, but for now, let us turn to the lighting of the Advent wreath. Because too many people are wandering in the dark, because too many people are sitting in the valley of the shadow of death, we light candles. Because people all over the world are suffering, and we are too busy to notice, we light candles. Today we stop everything and light these candles, one for hope. One for peace. One for joy. And one for love. May the light from these candles bring joy to the world. May the light from these candles light up the valley of the shadow of death. May the light and fire from these candles burn away everything that is stopping God's love from being born among us. Brothers and sisters, be not afraid. Even now, God's love is overwhelming the world. Purify our minds, God, that your Son, Jesus Christ, at his coming may find in us a mansion prepared for him who lives and reigns with you, one of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Please join me in the call to worship. My soul magnifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior. The Mighty One has done great things. Holy is God's name. Let us pray. God, our light and our salvation, you bring hope and peace to the lowly and oppressed. Let us see the world through your eyes, and that we may love the widow and the orphan, that we may work for justice and our lives bear witness to the good news of the kingdom at hand and our vocation. Serve to draw people to salvation through your Son, Jesus Christ, and the power the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Mary's mind. Please join me in the call to confession. Happy are those whose hope is the Lord. Let us seek God's help as we confess our sins. God is God, our Savior. We ask for your mercy. Though we have heard Mary's song, we still seek security in pride and power and possessions. Though we know your story, we resist the cost of following you. We pass by those considered lowly in this world. We turn away from hungry people who still wait to be filled. God, forgive us, we pray. Help us to work for the justice you intend. Make us messengers of the peace you bring. As we wait for you, turn our empathy into acts of love and service. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, Emmanuel. Amen. The good news is this. God forgives all our sins and promises to bring us to everlasting life. Friends, believe this good news and give thanks. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven.
Can hear them.
miracle. Will you help me? You do know the story, right?
Well, yeah, I think so. The first thing that happened is the angel appears to Mary.
Hold on to that thought. I don't want to be too late.
Singing. And so the shepherds and Mary and Joseph and all the angels and the animals squeezed into the barn to celebrate Jesus' birth. And there was a great rejoicing in all the...
Wait! Feels like someone's missing.
I don't think you can fit anybody else.
No, I'm sure there was somebody else. I'm supposed to tell. Oh, of course, there were three wise people. I guess they'll just have to be a little late.
So the angel went east to a faraway country and appeared to the three wise people.
Hail, wise people, God is with you.
Wow, what does that mean?
Well, in your case, it means that a new star appear in the sky. Follow the star until it stops, and there you'll find a baby Jesus. He will be called the Son of God and the Prince of Peace. He will teach people how to love each other, save them from sin, and give them life everlasting.
Let's go now and see the baby.
Well, we should bring presents.
Good idea. Let's bring him gold.
And frankincense and myrrh.
What is frankincense and myrrh?
Things that smell really good.
So the wise people came, and they brought Jesus gifts of gold and also frankincense and myrrh, which are things that smell really good.
Thank you.
That was a magnificent job done by our children for the children's musical, and I could not be happier to have them be a part of this worship service, even in these strange times. Thank you, children, for helping us to worship the Lord this day. My friends, will you join me in a time of prayer? If you have any joys or concerns that you would like to lift up, please, by all means, lift them up in the chat window, or feel free during the week to call the church office and let us know what's on your heart and on your mind. Let us join together now in prayer. Today, we will join with the song of Mary. Remember your mercy, O Lord, and help us, according to the promise of your steadfast love. Let all generations see your blessing, for your name is holy, and your mercy is great. Show the strength of your hand, and lift the burdens of the poor. Work wonders for the humble, and scatter the plans of the proud. Look with favor on the lowly, and cast down tyrants from their thrones. Fill the hungry with good things, and empty the hands of the greedy. Then we will sing out with joy and glorify you forever. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. We join in these words of Mary and lift up the prayer that her beloved Son taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Brothers and sisters, will you receive a blessing? May the peace of Christ go with you, wherever he may send you. May he guide you through the wilderness and protect you through the storms. May he bring you home rejoicing at all the wonders he has shown you. May he bring you home rejoicing once again into these doors. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, go in peace. Amen.